In this interactive simulation, we're looking at starting with a vapor-liquid mixture of water. We're going to do an adiabatic reversible compression, so that's an important aspect. And what the simulation allows us to do is to pick two displays. In this case, we pick pressure versus volume, and notice this is log of pressure and log of volume. And we've picked temperature versus entropy, and notice these are both linear scales. And since we have a starting point before the compression, that corresponds to the green point. So this is initial vapor quality of 0.4, and so it's here on the pressure volume diagram. You have to keep in mind this log scale with the vapor occupying much more volume than the liquid, and the entropy on the linear scale. So 0.4 is more where you might expect in terms of 4/10 of the way across. The third option is a pressure temperature plot, and we'll look at that when we look at the actual simulation. The other option then is the final pressure, which is the blue dot. So the idea is looking at the representations on different plots can give us a better physical understanding of what happens. Because we're looking at reversible adiabatic compression, this means the entropy doesn't change, so the blue dot is always going to be vertically on the temperature entropy diagram. It's going to have the same entropy as we started with. Of course, that's not vertical on a pressure volume diagram where we're decreasing the volume as we compress. If you notice from this diagram, if we continue to compress, we'll reach the saturated liquid line, so the volume will go to a much smaller value than the starting value. Now, as we do the adiabatic compression, we're doing work on the system. There's no heat transfer, so the energy increases. And this results in a temperature increase. And of course, we have to have a temperature increase to stay in vapor-liquid equilibrium as we increase the pressure. But we can do enough work, even if the temperature increases, we can raise the pressure enough to get to all liquid or to all vapor, depending on our starting conditions. So let's look at this interactive simulation to get a better understanding of this behavior. So here's the simulation. What we've done is we've selected the pressure volume plot on the left. And remember, this is log pressure and log of volume, and the temperature entropy plot on the right, and these are both linear scales. The green dot now is our starting point, and we can adjust the quality of that. The pressure is fixed, so using this slider, I can increase the quality. And then the final pressure, the blue dot, I can adjust by moving this slider. So we're doing adiabatic compression. We're starting in this case with a quality of 0.65, 65% of the water's in the vapor phase. And as I increase the pressure adiabatically, well, the temperature's increasing because I'm doing work on the system. And as we continue to increase the pressure, you notice that we're going to reach the case where we have all vapor. So even though we're compressing, we're also doing work, and the temperature increases, the energy goes into vaporizing the liquid, and we end up with all vapor if we just limit the pressure. But let's reset here, and let me go to an even higher quality. And so now, as I increase the pressure, I can get into the vapor and the supercritical temperature regime. The pressure is right around supercritical. And so we're going to all vapor because we're starting, we're doing this at constant entropy, and we're starting at an entropy that's higher than this critical entropy. If I again reset and look at the case where the quality is lower, and now I increase the pressure, I have all liquid. And of course, now increasing the pressure to liquid, I don't change the temperature very much, but I can change the pressure significantly. The other plot that we can look at is a pressure temperature diagram. In some ways you could say this is less interesting, but it's important to understand the distinction. This now is a log scale with a much larger range, and as I increase the pressure, well, let's go back here. As I increase the pressure, I stay on the two-phase line until, in this case, I have all liquid, and now I'm in the all liquid regime. The pressure is increasing without the temperature changing very much at all. So the idea here is to try and understand reversible adiabatic compression when we start out with a vapor-liquid mixture.